the Filipino whiskey aficionados are in for a treat with the return of Whiskey Live Manila at the Makati Shangri-La later this month. Johnson Lee is here with us today to tell us more about this highly anticipated event and how's the whiskey market doing. He's the CEO and founder of New Prestige Wines and Spirits. Johnson, good to have you with us in the show.
Good afternoon. Thank you for inviting me to explain about Whiskey Live Manila.
Now, Johnson, as the CEO and founder of New Prestige Wines and Spirits, you know, for you, what sets your whiskey brand or your brand apart in the competitive Manila market?
Definitely in the past few years, if not decades, the Philippine economy is growing. So, and definitely Filipinos are more exposed to the global world. We want more choices. We want better quality. And we just saw this opportunity and we took advantage of it.
And given the significant growth in the Philippines' market when it comes to alcohol and maybe whiskey, we've had so many discussions with other companies as well. How has your company adapted to meet the changing demands and preferences of consumers? You know, what has been key to differentiating your brand from the rest?
Yeah, so I think I better explain to your audience what I do. So basically, we import different brands from abroad. Whiskey originally is from Europe, primarily Scotland and Ireland, but things are evolving. Whiskey are being produced in Japan, Taiwan, Australia. So that's basically our overall goal, to bring more products to our market. So the younger consumers has better choices, and we also want to educate them about, you know, the basic stuff about our industry. Yeah. So basically, like what I said, we saw an opportunity. It's a growing market. Philippine population is quite young, and our industry as a whole, we are very bullish in the next few years.
So you do import brands. When you're choosing these brands, I guess, are there any regional or cultural influences that is inspiring the importation of certain brands compared to others, you know, especially catering to diverse tastes of Filipino markets?
Both. So definitely regional factor is a big thing. I mentioned Japan. Japan, everything made from Japan, whether food, automobiles, definitely whiskey, is on the rise. So that's part of our regional strategy in terms of supply chain. At the same time, cultural, you can also say historical, because, of course, for the longest time, whiskey originally, like I mentioned earlier, was created in Scotland and Ireland. So culturally and historically, it is still a big factor for our market.
Johnson, can you tell us more about, you know, this whiskey renaissance really flourishing globally? What trends do you foresee shaping the industry?
So the way we see the market today is, of course, just like stock market, just like business, we want to anticipate what's going to happen in the future. Definitely, we see a huge growth for brown spirits in particular. So whiskey falls into the brown spirits category because primarily brown spirits, the product has quite a long history. It has provenance, it has tradition. So the staying power for consumers is quite strong for whiskey. Basically that's it.
What are your specific markets or demographics right now, and what do you see the company targeting, considering the evolving preferences and also expanding the consumer base in the whiskey industry?
So, Philippine market, like I mentioned earlier, is quite young market. We are targeting sophisticated, quite affluent, well-traveled Filipino individuals, middle class and above. And I know our middle class is growing quite fast. If I'm not mistaken, Philippine economy is projected to be among the biggest 20 economies in the world in the next few decades. So we are preparing definitely basically catering to the younger audiences.
And Whiskey Live Manila really has become a global phenomenon, very much talked about. How is your company using this event to leverage to showcase your products on an international stage?
So if I can plug about Whiskey Live. So basically, Whiskey Live is happening next week, next Friday and Saturday, October 27, 28. It will be held at Shangri-La Makati. Event starts 5 and it will end 12 midnight. So for young people or middle-aged people that are interested to learn more about our event, you can log on to our website. Website is whiskeylive.ph. We have many programs available during the event. So you can join master classes, you can join some workshops, you can just participate in the main ballroom or in the main hall. So hopefully your viewers will be interested. Just please log on to whiskeylive.ph.
Now, Johnson, we all know that Whiskey Live Manila, they have this VIP section and exclusive tastings really do offer a unique experience. That's why some people want to attend these events. Are you able to elaborate on maybe rare and exclusive whiskeys that your company will be featuring this year?
Definitely. So this year is actually, so Whiskey Live Manila, this year will be our 6th year. We started back in 2016. And it is the first year that we are offering a VIP area. Only maximum of 100 people are allowed to visit per day. Some of the whiskeys that will be available there will be like really, really premium brands like the Macallans, the Glenrothes, Royal Salute, Martell Cognac, Remy Martin Cognac, Camus Cognac. So I also like to mention that although the event name is Whiskey Live Manila, We do offer other non-whiskey categories as well, such as cognac, tequila, and rums. So yeah, so those are the only few products I can mention for the VIP area. But hopefully, if you guys can participate, I'm sure you will be enjoying a lot, and you'll be surprised at the offering we have on the VIP section.
Lastly, Johnson, for attendees who may be new to Whiskey Live or to your brand, what would you recommend as a must-try from all the brands that your company carries, and why? This time, it's your personal recommendation.
So anyway, for viewers out there, we have more than 50 brands, participating brands, next week during the event. Definitely do try all of them, but I want to give my I have many choices. Among my many choices is a brand called Bruichladdich. Bruichladdich is actually owned by a company called Remy Cointreau, or they also own a cognac brand called Remy Martin Cognac. So Bruichladdich is quite a unique product because it emphasizes more on terroir. So for all wine lovers out there also, you probably know the term terroir, or meaning terrain. So it's quite a unique whiskey compared to all the rest in the market today.
Johnson Lee of New Prestige Wines and Spirits. Johnson, good to have you on the show.
Thank you. Thank you very much.